With the 21st overall pick in the 2020 NHL Entry Draft, the Columbus Blue Jackets are proud to select, from Avangard Omsk of the Continental Hockey League, Yegor Chinakhov. Now that we're in a position in the NHL free agency period where the news has slowed down a little bit, the stories, the trade rumors, they've kind of taken a little bit of a backseat, and we're now approaching what feels like midsummer territory, July, June kind of territory when it comes to hockey discussion. Let's talk about the draft. Let's talk about the 2020 NHL Entry Draft and some of the more interesting picks that ended up going down, because this one over here, Yegor Chinakhov, was one that if you saw my reaction live, the Blue Jackets, who are they going to take? They're proud to select Avangard Omsk, Yegor Chinakhov! Whoa! That is a reach! Yeah, you could kind of tell. I was kind of surprised. Yegor Chinakhov was a guy who wasn't really supposed to be taken anywhere near the first round, depending on who you asked. But he's a guy who a lot of people would define as the number one most surprising pick in the first round, the biggest reach, and the pick that caught everybody the most off guard. It's actually kind of funny because the second pick that a lot of people would say is the surprise of the first round was number 20, Shakir Makhamadoulin going to the New Jersey Devils, which was a pick before Chinakhov. But again, Chinakhov is who we're talking about here. The Columbus Blue Jackets took a guy who was supposed to go, according to future considerations, 249th overall. That's not even in the draft. The draft has 217 picks. Yegor Chinakhov was ranked by future considerations to not even being drafted. McKean's, though, had a different opinion. They had this guy at 49th overall, which was seen by some as a little bit high up, by others as a little bit too high up, but 49th would have been a second round projection nonetheless, and NHL Central Scouting had Yegor Chinakhov as the 30th best European skater. Again, European skater, which means the North American guys aren't included, which means that if you took the North American guys and the European guys and you mesh them together, this is a guy, depending on the talent of the North American guys, that might not have even gone in the second round, according to NHL Central Scouting's projections. So who exactly is Yegor Chinakhov, and why was he such a big deal? Well, he is the only overager taken in the first round of the draft. In fact, he was the only overager taken in a long span before the overagers started getting their names taken off the boards. He was born in February of 2001, making him 19 years old at the date of the draft, and he played this most recent season, 2019-20 mind you, in the MHL, where he had 69 points in 56 games played. He was able to get himself 27 goals and 42 assists. He was a guy who was noted by his goal-scoring ability, and he was pretty okay as a guy in the MHL who was turning 19 years old. However, if we take a step into his draft year, which was the year before that, the first year he was eligible to be drafted in the NHL Entry Draft, where he played for the Omsk Yastrebi in the MHL, he had 16 points in 37 games played. Not super impressive, but that's kind of why he wasn't drafted in the first place. However, it's not necessarily his MHL production in 2019-20 that put him on the radar towards being drafted in the first round by Columbus. It's what he's been doing in the KHL this current season that's pushed him into that spot. Because right away, taking a look at the numbers, he's 19 years old, playing in the KHL, he's at 9 points in 16 games played. 6 goals, 3 assists, he's got a great shot, he knows how to wrist it. His goal-scoring ability and the display he has shown in the KHL was one of the prime factors that contributed to this push up in the draft rankings. In fact, if you go over to his KHL profile and take a look at his game log, you can see that in the first 7 games of the season with Avangard Omsk, he only had 1 assist. So if you remove that, and you take a look at his point production from there, the guy's got 6 goals and 8 points in 9 games played. 5 of those goals came in 5 games, and he's a guy who legitimately has been exhibiting success in the KHL after making a seamless transition, apparently, from the MHL last year. And this is probably the biggest example of a draft-worthy player whose stock was increased tenfold by what they did in 2020-2021, the season that technically is supposed to be after the draft, the virtual draft being held after these European leagues got started, really allowed some of these guys like Lucas Raymond, like Yegor Chinakhov, to show themselves off to the hockey world as more than what they showed off for 2019-20. And it was to the point where if you take a look at the Sportsnet broadcast, Sam Constantino, Friedman, all these guys, Brian Burke, they didn't know what to say. They didn't have a graphic for this guy. They didn't have any analysis. They just said he was a Russian winger. That's it. And it was completely out of left field. Again, future considerations had this guy 249th, and he went 21st overall, ahead of all these other draft-eligible first-year players, and as a guy who indeed is doing some pretty nice things in the KHL. In fact, there was a Reddit post on rHabs posted 2 weeks ago, talking about Yegor Chinakhov, saying, oh, he's a guy we should take in the 7th round, guys. And they talk about the goals, they talk about how he's a 19-year-old who is scoring, doing some great things in the KHL. There actually is a little bit of a scouting report that was discussed in the comment section from a user named Frecto Hay. This is from the Black Book, talking about how he's bad defensively, talking about how he's inconsistent defensively, and talking about how he plays in a conference that isn't really all too great. But at the end of the day, when you draft a guy like this, you draft a guy like this because you're saying, hey, you can score goals. Come to Columbus, do that for us. If you're bad defensively, we'll fix that. As long as you can score goals, that is what we want. And this is kind of where the philosophical talks of the discussion come in. Because a lot of people were criticizing Jarmo Kekalainen for this pick. Not because the player is a bad player per se, but because of the talent that was available in the draft as well at that point. We had ourselves Jarmo Kekalainen, who came out and said, yeah, Chinakhov was in our top 10, despite being a guy whom some scouting outlets had as a mid-200s overall ranking player. So the idea of scouting philosophy starts to come in. Does this guy, who is doing really well in the KHL, but is an overager, deserve to be drafted over guys who are a year younger, but who could debatably have a similar, if not higher, offensive upside? Guys like Hendrix Lapierre, guys like Jacob Perreault. There were some guys available in this range that did seem like very high upside picks. And Yegor Chinakhov, in my opinion, definitely does have upside. It's just your own assessment of that upside at that spot in the draft. And if you're saying, okay, well, why didn't the Columbus Blue Jackets just wait until the 3rd round where they pick Samuel Kanasko, 78th overall, to take Chinakhov there? Well, according to Aaron Portsline, we have ourselves another NHL head scout in the Eastern Conference who said they had Chinakhov ranked 28th. That was not Columbus. That's a different team. So apparently, there actually seemed to have been some value on the draft floor for Yegor Chinakhov. Who knows, if it wasn't Columbus, it might have been some other team taking the guy who was ranked 28th on their board sometime in the top 40, the top 50, or the top 60. But at the end of the day, Jarmo Kekalainen has made some very weird picks that have indeed paid off. With the European leagues, for some reason, he has this weird talent to just find guys out of nowhere. You take a look at Kira Marchenko, second round draft pick in 2018. He was playing with Vasily Podkolzin, I believe. You have Alexandre Texier, who was taken in the 2nd round of the 2017 draft out of the French league. He completely took the hockey world by storm about a year ago. In that same draft in the 4th round, you had Emil Bemström, who was a great, nice depth piece. Obviously, back in 2016, you had the absence of Jesse Puljujärvi instead taking Dubois. That was a pick that was very surprising as well, but it seemed to have worked out in hindsight. So obviously, Jarmo Kekalainen kind of knows what he's doing when he's taking these swings, and that's kind of what I'm going to call this one, a swing. Yegor Chinakhov is a guy whom, when you mention him in a conversation, some people like to bring up the idea of Artemi Panarin, because Artemi Panarin was also a good KHL point producer by the time he was in his early 20s, his late teens, and he wasn't even drafted. For the guys who are taking a look at this pick, taking a look at just the numbers specifically, and saying if this guy at 19 years of age can consistently put up a goal a game or just under a goal a game per season in the KHL, that's the kind of guy you want in your system, because if he ever has NHL interest, you guys have him first. You guys have the rights to say, okay, this Kirill Kaprizov-like producer in the KHL by the time he's in his early 20s, this Nikita Gusev-like player in his mid-20s, this Artemi Panarin in his mid-20s kind of player, you want to come to the NHL? Hey, we've got your rights. Come over to Columbus, man. We need a top scorer. So, philosophically, it does make sense, but it's just whether or not you would have wanted to use that as your primary argument in making a draft pick like this, because again, this guy was ranked by a lot of people to go super late. Some people didn't even have him ranked at all. He was the first overager taken by a mile here in this draft. So, Talk to me in the comments what you think about Yegor Chinakhov, the pick, the prospect. We've spoken about a few things regarding that, as well as the team that picked him too. Tell me what you think in the comments below if you enjoyed this video. That's Rosa99. And bye.